How can the Australian farmer produce more mangoes? Do they use some techniques and secrets like KFC? Farmers and mango growers around the world have often asked these questions. However, only a few know how Australia can produce over 46,000 tons of mangoes every year. If you ask any farmer in Australia about how mangoes should be grown, he will see you with a quizzical look because sharing secrets isn't allowed. So, how do Australian farmers produce such higher yields of mangoes than any other in the entire world? What technologies do they use, and is there any secret they don't tell the world? And the interesting part, how are Australian mangoes available in winter, when no one mango variety could be found? Hello, everyone. Glad to have you back to another exciting episode of our channel. The Mechanicals brings you engineering marvels that are revolutionizing the world in one way or the other. If you are new to the channel but enjoy learning about how technology and innovation are shaping the world's future, you will love to watch the videos we post on this channel. In this video, we will tell you how Australian farmers produce thousands of tons of mangoes every year. Watch the video until the end to know how Australian mangoes have become an every time available fruit. Let's get started. Within recent years, the mango crop in Australia has flourished, offering employment to thousands of people throughout the country. In the past, little did people know about Australian mangoes dominating the markets today. One of the reasons for that is simply because farmers didn't feel mangoes should be harvested. However, now, things have changed quite enormously. Farmers have diverted all their attention to mango crops, which is why Australia can produce over 46,000 tons of mangoes every year. That's no less than an agricultural feat where farmers united and decided to produce the best quality mangoes. Every farmer in Australia has their own methods and secrets for mango crops, which makes the total yield quite diverse and maximum. Therefore, let's go through the journey of how mango seeds and plants are transformed into trees to have a breathtaking yield of mangoes. And here begins the journey. Before we continue further, tell us, are you loving the video? If yes, please like and share the video and subscribe to our channel for more videos where we unveil breathtaking engineering and innovative marvels. Let's continue now. It all starts when farmers start laying the groundwork for sowing and planting. The best time for planting mango plants and seed sowing in Australia in late spring. Therefore, farmers start preparing the fields and fencing them so the seeds can be sown or mango plants can be planted. If farmers want to have mango crops earlier, mango plants are planted instead of seeds. Mango seeds would take some more months to become plants, which are then taken care of to have mango harvest. Usually, farmers prefer using mango plants by planting them in the new fields they have prepared. Instead of using solid fences, a metal wire framework is laid around the plants, which also works as a coaxer to prevent plants from tilting. One of the reasons why mango farms don't produce maximum yield is mango plants' tilt growth. However, as we said, this is considered the basic problem that needs to be solved in Australia. The metal wires are used as a pivot, and plants are coaxed to grow by climbing and following those wires. Once plants are planted, and their leaves and stems are pivoted along the wires, the next period starts. It should be noted here that all the farmers use available data about all mango crop factors that can affect the harvest. Farmers know when to use fertilizers and when to use which fertilizer. Variation in the time of giving fertilizers is what determines the yield. No hard and fast rule exists for all the farmers to follow, therefore, farmers in Australia use the trial and error method for learning. Some give fertilizers during the day, while others give them at night. Some give less nitrogenous fertilizers at night, while others give more prosperous fertilizers during the day. Early summers are the period when plants become trees. From this point, it will take 105 more days to have a mango harvest. And once this period passes, farmers start to see heavy, shiny, succulent, and fleshy mangoes hanging from trees. The reap period starts, and the farmer brings in the necessary machinery to pluck all the mangoes. Mostly, farmers prefer plucking the mangoes by hand and poles so as not to affect the mango trees. Once they are plucked, they are washed and graded according to their quality. They reach factories and conveyor belts from the farms, where they will be washed properly and divided into various parts. They will be separated according to their weights, sizes, and conditions. Some of them would be packed so they could be exported. Others would be peeled and cut into cubes and packed in this form. At the same time, some are used to make juices. Hence, you can get Australian mangoes in any form you like. You can get them straight from the farms or buy them once they are graded. You can buy them in cubes, which you can eat directly, or drink mango juice. But how have Australian mangoes become a 12-month available crop? Let's reveal the secret all the Australian farmers use. They all use the same fertilizers and techniques that farmers throughout the world use, however, with one difference: timing. Australian farmers have used the trial and error method to know when they should plant, when they should give fertilizer, and when they should not. That's the secret they use, which creates a major difference in the yields. The 11 herbs and spices behind the mango crop are the timing which every farmer decides for their own crop. When every farmer is trying something new and has the results of their experiments, they can share the findings with all the farmers in the region. This way, the entire farmer community continuously purifies the techniques and secrets to reach the best one. Farmers in Australia say you have to be there at the right place and time. In other words, farmers have to decide which field would be suitable and when fertilizers should be used. Usually, fertilizers that lower nitrogen levels and increase calcium levels are given during the day. While during cool nights, potassium nitrate should be sprayed. Australian mangoes have become a 12-month available crop because some farmers use precise methods to extend the harvest period. In other words, farmers try to extend the growth period so trees flourish and bring yield off-season. This is largely done by shunning growth in the summers by selecting locations where trees cannot grow their roots properly. They will take more time to grow roots, extending the time and, thus, giving a later season fruit. In other words, mango trees are limited from having early flowers. The flowering period is delayed for a later crop. Farmers would divide their farms into two parts to have mangoes throughout the year. In the first part, seasonal mangoes would be grown, with different timing. While in the second part, fertilizers are used differently to extend the harvest period. Some farmers would cut the rings around the mango trees in the off-season, which can break out flowering. This is followed by a late mango yield, which can be reaped near winter and sold for more money. Even some farmers use chemicals to suppress trees' growth, so they don't grow violently and rapidly. Those chemicals go to tree roots and limit trees from growing too high or too fast. One of the blessings only Australian farmers enjoy is a natural atmosphere and pollinators like bees, which all collectively play crucial roles in supporting the off-season crop. Consequently, Australian farmers are more equipped with techniques they learn from self-experience and their fellow farmers. All of them work for one reason: to increase yields. Do you think Australian farmers use secrets to have maximum yields? Or is it just the location and fertilizers that help them produce the premium quality mangoes that could be exported throughout the world? Would you want to have your own little mango farm using all the techniques the Australian farmers use? Comment right below in the comment section. Do you think Australian mangoes are the best and don't have any parallel? Do you want to watch more videos like this one? If yes, please like and share the video and subscribe to get more videos on technological feats that are changing the world. Until the next video, stay tuned.